The lights are on at the indoor hall next to the Olympic Stadium. They are bright and unforgiving. The expectations for Team USA could not be higher. There's Carly Patterson along with Mohini Bardwaj, the 25-year-old captain out of UCLA, and Anya Hatch, the one-time, seven-time Cuban national champion. They will begin on vault. The first of four apparatus, no safety net. All three scores count. Talk about the expectations and handling the pressure in a situation like this.
Well, it has been four long years. Marta Caroli at the helm, and from the beginning, they laid out a plan to get them to Athens with athletes like Anya Hatch right here who could deliver not a medal, but a gold one.
Anya will come a little bit later. The United States will start with Carly Patterson, and this is a no warm-up situation. Team USA warmed up this afternoon. There is a practice gym, but you come out and go.
She was perfect night one on this.
You know what, Al? This is what makes this competition so difficult. With three athletes up, every score counting, Carly was to set the stage for Team USA. That was not as good a vault that she performed in night one.
She's checking up at the replay board in the corner of the arena, and she looks pretty upset.
Well, she knows that she landed low. Her chest was down near her legs, and that's a big deduction. She knows it's going to come. Usually, in a gymnastics meet, you put up your weakest vaulters first. There it is, 9.325. And if you can set a big score off the bat, then athletes like this one, Mohini Bardwaj, can bring in the really big numbers.
Looked like her Olympic career was over when she didn't make the team in 96. Then she went to UCLA, was one of the last to qualify out of nationals, survived the Olympic selection process. Here she is.
Oh, huge vault.
That's why she was brought to this Olympic Games.
Makes it look so easy. I guess she should. She's been doing that vault for almost 10 years now.
The start value of this vault is a 9.8. We've actually seen Mohini score 9.7. This was wonderful. Good height.
Much better than she did in night one. That's going to certainly help the USA quite a bit.
Mohini gets a 9.5. A little bit of a pick-me-up for Team USA. And now the final of the three. Anya Hatch, as far as this team final tonight, she was brought here just for this. No other event, just these few seconds. Might as well make the most of it.
Wow.
Big vault.
That was huge. She didn't really deliver night one, but that one, fantastic.
Anya's coach and husband, Alan Hatch, said that sometimes Anya thinks about the stick a little bit too much. She just needs to let it happen.
Anya checking out the replay for herself, and in a moment we'll see what the judges saw in her routine. And she's going to get the best score for the United States of the three, a 9.5. 6-2. But already we can say of the United States what we said many times in the day of qualifying. They can be better. They are the world champions. When we come back, they'll have to deal with the scores of the defending Olympic champions, Romania. Next up for the United States, Destination Uneven Bars. Carly Patterson wants to make up for a rough start on the vault. She'll be joined by Taryn Humphrey, who seems to get better each and every day. And then there's Courtney McCool, looking for the perfect ending to her comeback story. Rotation two of four, and for the United States, it means heading to the uneven bars, which is a strength. What do they want to get done here?
They want to get done a lot, and they should. They're a much stronger team than the Romanians on bars, and after three routines from the U.S. and three from Romania, those first and second places should flip-flop, and the U.S. should be on top.
First up for the United States will be Carly Patterson as she gets ready for the uneven bars. you have to think that she has shaken off whatever she felt after the vault.
Hey, listen, just to put it in perspective, after the first night of competition in the team, the three athletes that are going up for the U.S. tonight did not score below a 9.6 on this event.
So high expectations. Three gymnasts go, and all the scores count.
A lot of what you should be looking for on the uneven bars is good open shoulders, nice handstand positions. If you achieve that, you incur less deductions and obviously then the higher score. And that was a little bit of a mistake. She's doing fine though. She dealt with it quite well. Kind of flipped some of the elements around in her exercise. Oh boy.
Out.
Oh.
How bad was it?
Not good. Not good at all. She messed up her transition from the low to the high bar and didn't have enough energy at the end of her kip up.
She was actually in a dead hang.
So this is two disappointments in a row for Carly Patterson.
Well, as Elfie said, she was 9.6 plus on day one, but she just catches here with absolutely no swing.
Has to muscle this part up. That's a tough, tough position to be in to get more momentum to keep going.
And that causes her to not scooch her feet past that low bar, and she smacks him.
Have you ever seen her do that on uneven bars?
Never.
9.287. The United States is going to have to get some tenths from somewhere else.
Yeah, when it comes down to it, that's about 0.4 of a point right off the team total right there, that one exercise.
What a great Olympic story Taryn Humphrey is writing for herself. Far from being a lock to be named for the team, not only has she been named to the team to come here to the Olympics, but she's been very, very solid.
She's been so consistent. In every single workout that I have witnessed, the first day of competition, you know, she looks totally unaffected.
First release right here. She'll do a couple in a row. All in combination, very nice. Excellent.
You hear her teammates going through the routine with her in the background. How about this kid?
Just like everything else she's done in Athens, awesome.
Coaches Kelly Hill and Evgeny Marchenko. If you're wondering where Marta Caroli is, we can't get a shot of her because she's back with the other members of this team in the practice gym next door.
And you know, speaking of Marta Caroli, she has always said great things about Taryn Humphrey. One of the things that she absolutely loved about her is the fact that she knows how to hit and stick.
And after what happened to Carly Patterson, that is exactly what this team needed to see and did get to see. 9.575 for Taryn Humphrey. And now damage control. Boy, if as a coach you can learn how to get an athlete to forget about it and move on. Courtney Coupettes. Her story is all about coming back from a torn Achilles tendon in about a year. Marta Caroli, the woman who was part of the selection that put Courtney Coupettes on this Olympic team, said at the time that should have been a career-threatening injury. Guys, Carly does not look good.
No, she doesn't, and she recognizes that her routine certainly will cost a handful of tenths for Team USA, but Courtney Kupets has the ability of bringing in a gigantic number. She is a former world champion on this event.
Mom, dad, and family are here in Athens.
What's the height of this? It's great.
Just the dismount.
And I don't know if you saw that, Al. When she landed, she was a little under-rotated. And those toes of hers, they just dug into that mat. It was like, no way, don't move those feet.
So that saves the day on uneven bars to a certain amount. Obviously, they're not going to get as much as they were going to get, but after Taryn Humphrey and now the score that Courtney Kupets is going to get, the United States has to think they can come out of uneven bars, maybe even with the lead.
And this is going to be a big-time score. I mean, what Courtney does so well is she hits all her handstand positions, and check out the height on this release skill. That's amazing.
And look at her gritting her teeth to fight through it.
Well, you know, Al, even with the misstep by Carly Patterson, I think this is going to be enough. The USA will move ahead of Romania. They are just not that strong. And a 9.662, that's going to help their cause tremendously.
Romania next.